everybody. This is Jennifer with ChoiceSlides.com, and this will be a really quick tutorial for the new grid styles and transitions. Once you have all of those styles imported, you'll see that I'm in the new Producer 7, and they've added the ability to see which styles have captions, and that actually can be really helpful. In this particular style pack, you've got lots of similar styles. Some of them have captions, some don't. So this is actually pretty handy when you're just looking at these styles to look over here to decide to make sure that you're choosing the right style if you want a caption or not. So if you have all of these imported, you'll see that they are under a new category called grid. The transitions, if you have already purchased the other grid transitions, you'll notice that they do look different. The original grid transition styles are these black and white ones, and they are smaller and there are more of them. So if you use the grid slide styles with the older grid transitions, the grid won't match up because they're not quite the same. So that's why these new ones are called grid style grow random left right, because they're the grid is slightly different than the older ones, but they're under a new category called grid. Now if you have the old ones, they actually are not in this category. They're actually in choice slides. What you can do is highlight those grids, the grid transitions here. Just I hit my shift key and selected them all, and you can hit categorize and then scroll through here and click grid, and those will, that will add them to the grid category. That way you'll have all of them in the same place. That's, again, that's only if you have the old the older grid transitions. So just to get you started, you can, these are very, very simple to use. There's really not much to them. They all have just two keyframes, and you'll want to make sure that your subject stays in frame. That's pretty much it. The only thing to look out for, if you are going to use captions, you're going to choose which style based on the way your photograph looks. So let's say I want to use this photograph. I'm going to want my caption, if I'm using a caption, to be anywhere other than the upper left-hand corner probably. So in this case, I might want it in the lower right-hand corner. So I would choose effects, come over to my slide styles. And in this case, I've only got one photo, so I would choose the one photo with caption in the lower right. Okay, and I'll hit apply to style. Okay, and now I'm going to hit done, and we'll have a look at it. And most likely your photo may move in a weird way, so then that's fine. So there's my photo, and he's scooting down, and I really don't want that. So this is something that you'll probably have to do, and it's really simple. Just keep your subject in frame. So in this case, my second keyframe comes down. I'm just going to move it up so that his face stays in the center there. That's it. I'm done. Of course, then I'd just have to change my text. But you can have your text here. Again, there's lower right, lower left, upper right, upper left. That way you're going to choose based on your photo that you have. You can also obviously apply these to blank styles and then drop them in. Let me do, say, three photos, tall, wide, left. And again, these all come in different arrangements, okay? And it's hard to see with the itty-bitty thumbnail, but if you click on one of them, particularly with the three up here, it'll show. So this one says three photos, wide, tall, right. And the way the wording is, wide's on the top, tall's on the bottom, and they're both on the right. So this other three photos, tall, wide, right, tall's on the top, wide's on the bottom, they're both on the right. So that's how I named it. If you can't see this little thumbnail, look over here to see if that's what you're wanting. So I'm going to click done because I've applied it. With multiple layers, it's too hard to drag and drop into because you can't see your place markers. So if you open up this style, I did label them. If you're using 7, you'll see a little blue kind of text bubble. If you're using 6 or 5, it's a green eye, but that lets you know which layers you're dropping into. And I've tried to label them. This is the tall photo, this is a small wide, and this is the big wide. Okay, so in this case, the tall and wide are on the left side. So if I were to choose a photograph for the big one on the bottom, I'd want to make sure that my subject is somewhat on the right, because the other two place markers are over on the left. Okay, Actually, and that doesn't look bad. I'm not going to change anything there. Now, both of the place markers on the left are under masks. So even though this says tall photo, you could probably put a wide one there if you want to, because it's going to be under a mask, which means it's going to turn into a tall one no matter what you do. So I'm just going to grab a tall and put that there. And they don't move, by the way. So the two on the side don't zoom in or anything. So if you want to make adjustments, say for this one, I want that to be zoomed in a lot. So I would do my adjustments on the second keyframe. I'm going to zoom in a bit and maybe readjust it to there. And then I'm just going to copy, right click, copy to previous. That way it doesn't move. Okay, but it still will come in because it's the mask actually that's animated, not the photograph. Okay. Then I just need a wide one on the bottom, and I'll just grab this one. And there you go. And again, let's just say I want it to be fill the wide frame a little bit better. I can just zoom in a little bit and move it down, and just don't forget to right click, copy to previous, and that way it just fills up that mask much better. The less dead space, the better. For these slide styles, okay? That's just about it. Again, for the most part, you can't make these changes on the first keyframe because you can't see them yet. So all of those changes will be made to the second keyframe and then copy to first, except for the wide one, that one grows. So for the big wide photo in the back, you would just move the position if you need to. Okay, the only other style that I need to show you is the title. There's obviously no layers in this. This is just a title slide. This background does come with it. This is one of my earlier abstract backgrounds, but I just wanted to show you really quickly that you can change the color of the video file. So I'm going to close that and open my slide options window, and the abstract 24 is the bottom layer. If I want to change, say I'm doing something with my school colors and my daughter's school is the Wolverines and it's blue. So I would just click colorize. I'm in the adjustments tab. I would click colorize and then click on this gray box and then pick my color and find the exact color that I need. Now, if you have a photo that you're matching, the little eyedropper tool is awesome for that if you need it, you know, to match an exact color, and hit set color. And there's my title. And now I can change the color of the background to be whatever I want. And that's it. Your transitions, again, are in the grid category. And again, as I mentioned before, the new ones that match this particular style pack all have images for thumbnails. The earlier ones are all black and white. And you can just play around with these. The grid style random was what I used mostly in the preview video. It's very seamless. Your audience will barely know that there's a transition there. The grid style grow is very obvious. The right and left wipes will work with very specific photos, maybe those that are facing the right or left. And then the grayscale, of course, just gives you that nice color pop at the end. So grid style random, if you did a whole show with grid style random, your audience would probably never know where the transition is other than the fact that your photos are changing. But the squares match the styles exactly. Okay, let me play this back and we'll see what that looks like. There's my slide style and there's the transition, and it's just very smooth going from one to the other, and you should have enough options between one, two, and three photos with and without caption to do an entire show using this set. Thank you so much for watching and allowing me to help you unleash your creativity.